Hello, grade 2 students. Welcome to this session on Book Creator, where you learn to create a new comic book. We'll start by pasting the link that you just received via your Zoom lesson from your teachers and opening the link on a Chrome browser window. We'll just wait for it to load. As soon as the window loads, you'll get to see an icon where you'll get to choose your avatar. Go ahead and choose any icon that you like. You can go ahead. I'm going to just go ahead and choose the tiger here. There you go. And you'll notice that you don't have any books in your library yet, because that's what you're going to do. You're going to go ahead and start creating books in your library. How would you do that? You'd go ahead and click on this yellow color icon that says new book. That's what we're going to do. Click on the new book icon. And here, to make a new comic, we're going to choose any one of these three layouts that you see at the bottom. So I'm going to quickly start making the cover or the title page for your comic book by clicking on the portrait option. I'm going to click on the portrait option. There you go. Now we've got your cover page ready, but you notice that there's nothing on the cover page yet. We're going to add some text. We're going to add some effects on the cover page to make it look more exciting. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly add some effects on the background by clicking on this little button that says I. So I'm going to go ahead and click on I and choose one of these background options. In fact, if you notice at the bottom, there are so many background options, but I'm going to quickly go ahead and choose this color for my text layout. There you go. Now we've got a layout. We've got the background already here. I'm going to now add the next part that I'm going to go ahead and add a title to our comic book. To add the title, just besides the I, you'll notice that there's a plus symbol. I'm going to click on the add item option, and you'll notice that so many options come up on your screen. I'm going to go ahead and click on the text option to add the title. When I click on text, it's going to give me other options here, where I will go ahead and choose the title option. Then it opens up a small box where you can go ahead and rename your comic, and my comic's name would be My Awesome Comic. There you go. That's my name. You could go ahead and rename it your own comic to any other thing that you might have thought of. There you go. Now, if I want, I can go ahead and move this and align the box to wherever I want. Now, you'll notice that it's not properly aligned. You could go ahead and do that. You can go ahead and change the alignment of the text by clicking on, make sure that the box that has the text inside is clicked and selected. You can go ahead and click on the I symbol again, and you notice that there are three alignments here. That's left aligned. That's why you see that the my is on the left hand side, but we wanted to come on the center. So I'm going to click on this center align option to make sure that now it appears as if it's in the center. So I'm going to, you can go ahead and move the box to any position that you like. So if you don't really want it in this position, you could literally place it anywhere that you want. Top, bottom, bottom corner, top corner. But in my case, because I've chosen this layout, it looks better if I can keep my text in the center. That's what I've done over here. And if you don't like the font, if you want to change the color of the font, you could still go ahead and do that by clicking on this I symbol again. I'm going to click on that. If I want to change the color, I can go ahead and choose any other color that I want. But for now, I'm pretty happy with the red color that text that I've got. But if you want to go ahead and change your font, you can go ahead and choose other fonts if you want to. So you can go ahead and click on the font, and you've got so many options of different fonts that you can go ahead and choose for your comic book. All right? Yep. So you can do so many things with your fonts. And now the next thing that we got to do is, now that we've got a background for our book cover, and we've also got a title for our comic, the next thing that we're going to do is add the next page, or add the first page for our comic. So in order to do that, you'll notice that there are two arrows on either sides of your screen. If you click on this arrow that points to the right hand side, you'll get to see the next page option. I'm going to do that right now. Click on this. There you go. Now you've got a layout in which you've got two pages of your comic book open in front of you, and you'll see on top it says pages 2 and 3 of 3. So your book now has three pages. One is the title page, second page that you see on the left hand side, and third page that you see on the right hand side. You'll notice that there's a small dotted line in the center, which is for the fold of your comic book. In case if you want to print the book, you can go ahead and do that as well. But for now, my book is empty and I don't see, or I don't have the boxes that you normally have in comic books. Those boxes are called panes, and if you want to get panes in your on your comic book, you need to go ahead and click on this yellow symbol that has a plus symbol on it. Go ahead and click on that, and then the first option that you see is the panel option. I'm going to choose the panel option and choose any layout that you like. So it's totally up to you what you want to choose as your layout. I'm going to choose this layout, and that's how my panels would appear on the page. All right. Now, another thing if you notice is the background of my page is completely white. If I want to change the background color of my page, I would go ahead and click on the eye symbol again, and you'll notice this familiar layout that we used for our title page. I'm going to choose the same color that I chose for my title page so that it appears in the background. Now, the next step that we need to do would be to add our characters into our story. So in order to add characters into the story, what we could do is we could go ahead and upload images, because Book Creator does not provide any characters as such to add into your comic book. So you'll need to get images from the internet. So we can go ahead and go and use images that we can find from Pixabay. So Pixabay is a free search engine. It's also a safe search engine where we'll get images that are appropriate for your age. And so we'll go ahead and add some images from there, right? So I'm going to go ahead and open Pixabay, which is pixabay.com. And here I'm going to search for a character that I want for my story. So I'm going to go ahead and search for a wizard. Let me go ahead and see if there are images for any wizards. Oh, I've got quite a lot of images for wizards here. I will go ahead and choose, oh, this seems interesting. I'm going to choose this image. Okay, I'm going to click on this. And once I get the image here, there is an option for me to download this image. So I'm going to go ahead and click on download. So I'm going to clicking on free download here. And then you have different numbers. You can choose the one that says PNG. So either one of these images should be okay. You can download any image, but look for images that are PNG, because that will not give you a white color background when you add this image in your comic book. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly click on download. Okay, and then it might show you this option to select or say that I'm not a robot. So I'm going to, you can go ahead and click. So I'm going to click on download now. There you go. My image is getting downloaded. Next step that I need to do is upload this image that I've got into my comic pane. So to do that, I'm going to click on the plus symbol again. There are three options. We explored the comics option where we did panels. But now we are going to go into the media option to import. Okay, I'm going to click on the import option. And here you'll have different tabs. But the tab that we are looking to upload the image that we just got from the internet, from Pixabay, the option would be to click on files here. Click on files, please. And now it would show a small window where you could go ahead and click on the upload option. So my image is downloaded somewhere here. And I'm going to click on the wizard option and click on open. Okay, and let's see whether it gets uploaded. There you go. We got a wizard here on this panel. I can move the wizard around, but I want to keep him on the first panel here. So I'll try and fit him inside by clicking on this and moving him around. And if you notice on the top corner, there are these blue colored dots. If you click on them, and if you using your finger, if you bring them down or if you drag them down, you can change the size of your character. So that's how I change the size of the wizard. So the wizard is now much smaller than what he was when I initially uploaded him here. Now I'm going to add a speech bubble. The next thing to do is, he's not saying anything, so we want to add a speech bubble on him so that he says something or he narrates the first part of the story. So in order to do that, I'm going to click on the plus symbol and I'm going to use the speech bubble. You see the speech bubble over here? That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and click on the speech bubble. And you see the speech bubble has come up. Again, you can adjust the speech bubble to wherever you want. Because our wizard is in the first pane, first box, first white colored box, it will be better if we can fit the speech bubble within that pane. I'm going to adjust it very quickly. So you notice that it can also be made small, it can be made bigger, and you can adjust the size of it. Okay, that's what I've done. I've adjusted the size so that it fits within the first pane, and I'm going to write a small text. Hi, this seems to be an interesting book. Okay, there you go. So I've got, so if you want to adjust your box, again, you can go ahead and adjust the box so the text is completely visible. Now we've got our first pane of our comic where our wizard here has started reading this interesting book. And if you want to add a small title strip on top, you can go ahead and do that as well by clicking on this plus I option. And you go to text and you can put a caption here. So the caption is, I can mention, once upon a time, there was a wizard. And then you can add on to your story. I'm just going to add a small part of this text, and I can move this as the first part of the pane here and adjust it so that it fits the box that you see on top. There you go. So there's my first comic taking shape. I've added my first character here, and I've added a little bit of text on them. I had to get the character from Pixabay. I had to download it, bring that character here. Additionally, you can also take pictures of things around you. If you don't want to download images for which are characters from the internet, if you want to go ahead and upload pictures of things around you, and you want to make a story around or a comic around things that are around you, you can also use the camera option, which is in media. Again, go to the plus symbol and go to media, and here there is a camera option. Now our suggestion here is that because Book Creator is an app that runs on the internet, and the books that you create might be shared with others on the internet, we suggest that you don't take any selfies of yourself or of people around you. So ideally you could take images of objects or things around you, and that's what we suggest or recommend for now. All right guys, don't take images or don't take selfies of yourself. Don't put your own pictures. You can go ahead and choose images from Pixabay or from the internet, and then add those character pictures as characters or as backgrounds for your comic book. All right, so you could go ahead and choose the camera option, but remember, don't take selfies of yourself. All right, so the next thing is you can go ahead and keep adding more content by adding onto these panes and develop your story. And once you're done with creating one pane where you've got these two pages where you notice that these two pages have content in them, go ahead and click on the plus symbol to add the next set of pages. Like this, you can keep adding pages. Now you'll notice that this has a background, but it doesn't have any panes. So you need to go ahead and add panes for pages 4 and 5 of your book. So you're going to click on the plus symbol and go to panels and then choose the pane that you like or that you want to develop, or you want to add more parts of your story. So I'm going to quickly go ahead and choose this type of pane, but it's your choice of how you want to add panes. Again, within these panes, you can add images, you can add text, you can add backgrounds, all of that you can add within these panes. So go ahead and use the plus symbol to add all of these elements like how we showed you before. All right, guys, let us know if you have any questions. If you want to save your work, you need to go back to My Books here, or if you want to play your book, you can go ahead and play your book as well. You can read your book. You can also add another thing. You can add is you can add you can also record voice on this, so you can make it like an interactive book, like how you would do on Seesaw. If you added content on Seesaw, you could also record and narrate. So even your wizard, you can make your wizard talk as well. You can record your own voice and put your vocals on that. Comic book page if you want to. All right, so these are the options that you have for now, and you can press the play button if you want to and play your book and move the book around, and you can also select the read to me option. So once you've created the book, you can go ahead and rename the book as well. So if you want to rename the book, you can go ahead and click on edit, and you can go ahead and click on this option here, and you've got this title for the book that says a new book. So instead of a new book, you can rename this to My Awesome Comic, which is the title of my comic book. All right, guys. So that's about it. And if you want to sign out from here, you can go ahead and click on the sign out option, click on your profile picture, click on sign out, and your book should get saved within your account. Make sure you save this link and do not share this link that was shared to you by your homeroom, by your teacher, to anyone else, because this is your account and you're creating all these comics, and you should keep your comics safe and make sure that you don't save it with anyone else. Thank you guys. Let us know if you have any questions. We'll be glad to help you out. Bye-bye.